Miss Miranda, time for Bible. We've been talking about how to help those who are lost, how to help those who are hungry, how to listen to the stories or the parables that Jesus has given to us. Today, the last story of this week is called The Good Samaritan, and it's in Luke chapter 10. Once, someone asked Jesus what the law meant when it said we must love our neighbors as much as we love ourselves. But who is my neighbor? He asked. And Jesus told him a story. A man was going from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers who beat him and took everything from him before leaving him by the roadside half dead. Soon a priest passed by, and when he saw the man, he crossed to the other side of the road and hurried on his way. Didn't help him. Then a Levite came along. He also hurried on his way without stopping. The next person to come along was a Samaritan who belonged to a group not friendly to the Jews. Yet, when this traveler saw the man lying bleeding by the roadside, his heart was filled with pity. Means he felt sorry for him. He knew he needed to help him. He knelt beside him and carefully washed and bandaged his wounds before taking him on his donkey to an inn where he gave the innkeeper money to look after the man until he was well. Jesus looked at the man who had posed the question and asked who he thought had been a good neighbor to the injured man. Who was the neighbor? The Samaritan, that's right. The man sheepishly replied, the one who was kind to him. Then Jesus told him, go then and be like him. Boys and girls, you have a choice, and if you could be anything in this whole big world, showing kindness is a very good choice. It helps people. It helps you. Using your heart for kindness every day is the big kindergarten way, right? So Miss Miranda is proud of you for always thinking and doing like the Good Samaritan. I'll see you next time.